and welcome back to Octopath Traveler. I, not too long ago, did the demo, and this is around where we ended, and I actually played more of the prologue demo after that, so full game's out now. I started up a new save file and got to basically where I left off the last time. I actually have not done any combat yet, though, so
I'm just getting into it.
And after, sorry about that. After I finished off last time, I learned more about the combat because I probably didn't pay near enough attention to it really the first time. But now I have a little bit more of, see the BP boost point per turn. I didn't pay attention to this little thing at all, if it even showed up then, so I didn't realize that basically you get to attack multiple times when you have those, which is very helpful when you want to hit and whatnot, and also don't want to drag out a fight, because that just means you're going to get hit more. But since I figured that out, it's going to go a lot easier. But like I said, I went through a little bit more after this. I debated.
Out of my way.
I knew I wanted to do more with the scene, and I debated wanting to start and over with someone completely new. And basically pick a new starting character. But I figured it'd be easier just to pick off where we left off. Anyone who hasn't watched that previous one, I'll link back to that first part. Where I can admit that it was a bit of a slow start. It's definitely long. RPGs usually have a slow start, though, so. And definitely in the first part, I was more enamored with the graphics more than I was with anything else, so.
My turn.
But apparently, this boost point system is a carryover from the Bravely Default, I believe, series that the developers originally worked on. I heard people talking about that.
Don't play.
When mentioning this game, so, but I've never played those games. I think I even tried. I can't remember if that's when I tried and didn't like, or I think I didn't like it for story reasons. This one, I'm, like I said, I went into the demo a little bit more, or I enjoy it more than I thought I would. And good lord, I'm about to die.
I'll take this.
Okay. Also, I also realized the stealing mechanic that he has is basically, as long as it's 100%, there's no worries. Like, basically destroy, because it's not going to, it's only going to harm it when you have a chance of failing, and since it was 100% throughout that first part, I had no risk of failure. But I, being paranoid, thought, oh, it's still going to affect it in some way.
My turn.
Went against that and just didn't do it a good chunk of what I could have, but now I know. Steal as much as possible when I can. So I'm basically stolen from just about everybody. So I'm not at least when I'm talking about stuff. But it is, I definitely enjoyed the demo a lot, even after. Like, I had some misgivings about it, because I'm so curious as to how it's going to culminate together. And
my turn.
Also, heads up for what I'm going to be doing. This is basically just going to be me playing through everyone's first chapter, because no matter what, my goal was always going to be get everyone I
and that's that.
Get everyone I can. And once I get into the next part of this, I'll be able to show, like, what the map is, and where the other people are, and what direction we'll be taking, and even how it's showing that the story
will
be going
this quick.
And progressing.
My
okay,
turn.
You actually, I think, need this type of weapon? No.
My turn.
Oh crap, you're not vulnerable to any of my main things.
Don't
play. Oh, FP. Oh, I leveled up, that's probably why. Because I was like, my SP was gone.
That time. For you.
So.
Don't play.
I did not know I could do
that. Where's the nearest
moves.
Tavern?
That is still not. Just need to know. What I do know is basically. Actually, no, I'll wait until we get to the next part. So. I don't remember the map layout. And even then, I still know there are a couple items hidden around that I'm gonna wanna grab. Just cause I can. So. I'll still be fine in a little bit.
I'll make this quick.
But it is. Pixels are still the main thing, but anyway.
Don't play. Out of my way.
Picking this up at a. I always go to my local game store. I know not everyone. But there's a good chunk of people who just buy everything online now and. But I always find I prefer to go
out of
to
my way.
A store.
Let's do this! Where's
good
the nearest tavern?
Chunk of those people, I've always had, at least the store I go to, I always have good conversations with those people. I've never had a bad experience there. So. And even when I've had issues, they've usually been able to help me out and do what's best for me, for the most part, so. But. And luckily they were doing an early release for this one, so I could start recording as soon as possible.
This is the beginning of your end. Out of my way.
I admit, I've been watching a lot of anime.
My turn.
And if anyone else is a fan of G4 Star, and their anime FMK, 4-star bento channel.
Out of my way.
I was basically looking up into some of the ones I was curious about
out
that
of my way.
They had on their list for the next season. And I think there are some good ones. I found three, I believe, that I really like, and I hope, and I will definitely try to vote in. And I believe there's a good chance that they. Actually, no, I think I found two. No, three. And even
and
if you don't
that.
Watch that, but if you're a fan of anime, Cells at Work looks adorable. The only thing I'm worried about is them throwing a romantic element into it and just like, no, you don't need that. They're cute. They're cute separately. Just don't make her have this crush on this other character, just leave it as, if it's an admiration sort of thing, fine, just don't try to throw, make it, just
this
make
this
a quirky, fun
end.
Type of game, but, other than that, Cells at Work was very cute, and that one's basically, their describer of it's probably very accurate, is it's Osmosis Jones in anime form. If you don't know that, then I can't help you any further.
Out of my way.
It's basically cells. The characters are all cells of the human body, working to keep everything running. So, the main character is a red blood cell who delivers oxygen. I'm very curious, and part of me, I know in the first episode they have some large words that partially also because it's in Japanese that I'm watching, and it's just like, is that what I think it is, or is that another disease or thing that I'm thinking of? And so part of me wants to Google some of the terms that they're using and some of their science and see how accurate even is this. But it's still good anime fun. Animation's cute.
My turn.
A lot of the characters are defined by their appearance. Hey, you. Nah, if I could check. It was sick. We have to break that much of this. It's dead. Damn.
My turn.
Trying to remember how to pronounce the other name of the anime. Angamwah? About the Mongolian invasion in Japan?
And that's that.
That one also looks very good and fairly brutal. Ooh, yes, I have my new skill. I can get a skill now. This is gonna be good. Because that was one other thing I wanted to unlock. This is my favorite one. This is the one I unlocked first, and basically getting that 30 JP, like, I could get any of these at 30 JP. Share SP, steal SP, that one's also going to be fairly good and potentially my next one. But here's the thing. HP Thief, great to have. But I got to 30, now the next one's 100. So they take a huge, huge leap in cost, which just tells me how long this game will potentially be, which is also why I'm only doing partial. I also forgot that I had this one. Occasionally poisons target, yes. It's gonna be very helpful. I got that. Ooh, wind attire. That's better. Accessories. Better evasion. Sleep isn't really an issue. Or I don't know it to be. At the very least. Oh yeah, that was the same room I was in. Another healing grape. I feel like there's another save point coming.
Come on, I've got better things to do.
Angamwah.
Out of my way.
Very good also. The only thing I hate about it is it has this stupid film over the entire animation. And that's usually not a bother for me. I don't really mind that kind of stuff. Actually, no. I don't generally notice it. But I saw it, and I'm not able to unsee it now. And that bothers me more than anything, is I'm so focused on that, it's just like, you don't need this. The animation looks fine. Why is this necessary? And that's probably going to be my only sticking point of annoyance with that entire show.
Where's the nearest tavern?
You don't need this. Or if you do, explain to me what reason this is necessary, and maybe I'll accept it. But for the most part, it seems totally asinine. That's where we're going, by the way. That little blue jewel down there is exactly what we're looking for. So, very close to the end of this. Luckily, I vaguely know where I'm going. And this is like very
linear. This is the beginning of your end. My turn.
And the other one was Toho Animation. I don't know how to name it, but it's a Bagman anime. Animation wise, I like it. I'm pretty sure Toho has the same people who do Yoga Mushi Pedal, which I adore that show. That is my favorite sports anime ever. I vaguely want to read the manga, but the anime is
just
so good.
Don't start things you can't finish.
And I am desperately trying to find the OST for the second half of this last season. And so super excited for the next season. And part of my favorite thing about that show is the characters grow up and leave. Because I love Prince of Tennis. Prince of Tennis was one of my first sports animes. But basically, a lot of the characters were in their third year. And they're not gone. It's like, oh, we're done with high school stuff. Now we're going to do international stuff and across Japan stuff. So there are these characters that we've established, they're all coming back rather than make new characters and develop them. And like I said, I love them, but that's sort of also a huge just, why not make new characters? And that's one thing that this other show does, is it Yomamushi has new characters. All of its previous original, all of its third years from the first season graduated, and yes, they show up, but they're not in big of a role as they used to be, which makes me super happy. Because they're there for moral support of the characters that are still in the team. They give you that nostalgia for them still being there, but
come on, I've got
they're not there all the time,
do.
And there are other characters getting spotlight still. And that's a lot more fun to me. Even though I do think there's an issue with one of the new characters being way too similar to one of the previous ones. But that's not as big out of a sticking point in my opinion. I think at least it's a new character. And they are similar in their personality in some ways, but they also have differences in how they're being developed and how they're growing. It's not entirely one for one.
Out of my way.
And I think that's good overall. And I could gush about your evolution forever. Because it's just so good. And its cast is not enormous either. Because I have that with both
of my
sports anime. It's just like, I can't keep the characters straight anymore.
Where's the nearest tavern?
Especially Prince of Tennis. There's like 20 fucking teams. And I can memorize all the main team. But after that...